Oh.
That was a nice drive.
Sav is trying out my 44-inch shaft from LA Golf. And because she's getting so strong, right now she's kind of struggling from some, you know, workout lactic acid buildup. So she's a little stiff. But yet, hey, 104 miles an hour, 285-yard carry, 317 total is nothing to sneeze at. I mean, it's a beautiful drive. And one of the things that we wanted to talk about today was so many of you have this super strong grip and you're hooking the ball a lot and you're not sure what to do about it. You've gone to some instruction and they said, no, you need to have a neutral grip. And then what happens when you have a neutral grip, Sav?
I lose like 30 yards.
Minimum.
Yeah.
Like you lose everything.
Yeah.
And I know many of you are losing your, you're losing your shh, you know what I mean? So you love the feel of that strong grip and it's really important for you to keep it. I'm going to show you how to keep it. You really don't want to miss this show. This is one of the aspects that I've seen from Savannah my whole life. It was right there in front of my face and I just freaking learned why. I can't wait to show you. If we had a hammer, Sav, put your thumb there. Let me hammer your thumb.
I don't like the sound.
Put it thumb up. Okay, so if I'm hammering down on that thumb, you'll notice that my forearm and my hammer are in line with each other. Right there on that anatomical snuff box, that magic anatomical snuff box. So if you were to position the thumb lower, there we go. There, right about there. That's it, Sav. So now I'm just going to slam that nail right into your thumb. Mm. So notice how my forearm and the hammer are on the same plane. It isn't single plane because I've seen Mo Norman hit shots towards me, and when he did that, and now here's the optical illusion on that. We get the super strong grip. Beautiful, isn't it? That's hammering down, this is hammering through. So notice now I'm in a great position to hammer through, only if, there it is, my shaft and my arm, my forearm is on the same plane. So now it feels like I've got the hammer lined up with my forearm and I'm ready to go. Now, from face on, if I hit a shot in your direction here, notice how the club is on two planes, right? My arm and club. It is an optical illusion what single plane actually is. So from here, I get into a beautiful hinge, and now I can move towards the target. Notice how my hands pass, and now I'm collecting the ball here and hammering through the nail. So you collect the head of the nail here, and you drive it through the board in the direction of the target. Now, one of the so-called idiosyncrasies of your golf swing, and this was the same idiosyncrasy that was in Nancy Lopez's swing that you're going to see right now. Sav has this little lift of her hands at address. When she's braced, she's in that beautiful hammering position. And go ahead and just take a backswing, Sav. See how the hands levitated up a little bit? Mm-hmm. That's it. There's Nancy Lopez right there. So she would basically, the hammer would droop and then fall onto that plane and then move into that backswing.
Yeah.
And I've always resisted the urge to change that in your swing because I'm going, well, it looks really natural. It looks like a natural human movement pattern. And that's what I've actually become a specialist in. Rather than going, but tradition is going to say, well, no, you need a neutral grip and you need your hands low and you need to do all this stuff that everybody else is doing, or else you're going to look too strange. And we've always gone against that grain quite significantly, haven't we?
Yeah.
Okay. So let me get my driver and let me show you what it looks like for the right-handed swing. And we'll do a couple of different angles of that, all right? Holy mackerel! Woo! How sweet is that?
With a 44-inch shaft.
With a 44-inch shaft. Thank you very much. Wow, man, that was just blasted right down the center line again. All right, super strong grip. Let it droop there. Now it doesn't feel like it's going to hook anymore. Look at that. We had less than 500 side spin on that, and the backspin was 1600 RPM. So let me just show you real quick. There's my draw, and there are my numbers. Pretty cool, huh? This would be strong and snappy, and this is strong and draw. See the difference? Now my hammer is on that proper swing plane from the forearm all the way down the shaft, and now I'm taking the tip of the tee and I'm making it flip over that intermediate point right there. Wow. How good is that? So, on that. I played that as a fade. Did you notice I was a little more open on that one?
Yeah.
Strong grip. Up on plane. Up on the hammer plane. And there we go. That one's long down the middle of the fairway. So we hope you enjoyed that. All of you with those strong grips, we have your option. We've got what's going to save your game and prevent you from going to the dark side with that neutral grip. Enjoy that.